sacred journey around the place. In just 2 days, all the sacred spots around Dwarka can be seen. From Dwarka, visiting the Rukmini temple, Okha Bet Dwarka, pronounced as Bate Dwarka, Gopi Talab, and also the Nagnath Mahadev temple, and getting back to the starting point will be like a circumambulation. After a holy bath in the Gomati river and darshan of the Dwarka Krishna, in just 10 minutes, one should be in the Rukmini temple, 2 kilometers away. Rukmini enjoys a boon that only if her sanctum is had darshan of, all the punya or merit of the pilgrimage to Dwarka will accrue to the Yatrika, failing which half of it will go to her. Therefore, the 10 minutes journey to that temple should not be forsaken by devotees. The large number of sadhus sitting in rows outside the temple, raising their hands and uttering something in chorus on seeing the devotees coming out, provided a strange sight there. Expecting similar reception for me while stepping out of the shrine, I went inside for darshan. After darshan, while circumambulating, Tita is given to the devotees. Like drinking water, it is given in tumblers. On coming out, I learned that the sadhu sitting near the entrance were seeking alms, and we happily gave them some money. In gratitude, they raised their hands and uttered something in chorus. I was told it is customary for the person sitting first to receive the offering on behalf of all, the collections being divided later among all the group members. I felt how nice it would be if this custom were to be followed everywhere. Our journey to Okha did not take much time. Dwarka to Okha is 30 kilometers, and our vehicle went right up to the sea in Port Okha. After covering a short distance on foot, we could see mechanized boats lined up for taking pilgrims. We were in one such boat when my friend Nagarajan from Chennai called me on my mobile phone asking me where we were. I told him we were traveling to Bet Dwarka in a boat, and from the other end came the humorous comment that our boat should not go astray and enter the Pakistani waters, as we were only 40 kilometers from Karachi. In the next 20 minutes, we reached Bet Dwarka, which is a very small island. I visualized that the Dwarka created by Vishwakarma, as ordained by Sri Krishna, should have been many times bigger. Going through narrow lanes in the abode of Sri Krishna, we had darshan of Bet Dwarka Krishna. Vishwakarma's creation in the midst of the sea is referred to as Mukhya Dwarka. The Dwarka on the bank of the Gomati River is known as Gomati Dwarka, and the place we are surveying now is called the Bet Dwarka. It is said that in the Bet Dwarka, surrounded by sea, Sri Krishna had resided in the vicinity of the place, now standing out as the temple for him. Staying there, Sri Krishna was going to the Dwarka city in the mid-sea, exuding its splendor in gold and precious stones, situated away from the Gomati Dwarka for governance of his domain. While one was his abode, the other place was his administrative headquarter, gathered as a legend from the people there. Efforts are still on for the retrieval of the remnants of Sri Krishna's palace that existed in the Moola Dwarka from below the ocean. Some of the things brought out of the depths of the ocean are kept now in Dwarka for public viewing. In Bet Dwarka, there is a shrine for twin Hanumans at a distance of 4 to 5 kilometers. Otherwise, the place abounds in thorny bushes, plants and creepers. It's advisable to have darshan here before noon. It's only after 5 p.m. the temple is open again. By 6 p.m. the boat service will cease, and even a little delay will entail staying there for the night. Therefore, darshan here should be over before noon, and after gulping the free lunch offered by a trust at the dining hall there, the return journey across the sea could be undertaken in a mechanized boat as before. Without returning to Dwaraka straight from Oka, if a left turn is taken at some distance, the holy Gopi Talab area can be reached. Those desirous can have their bath in that sacred tank, but at least a sprinkling of that holy water on the head should not be ignored. The Gopi Chandana available there may be bought, and after having darshan of Sri Gopinatha and Gopika, Sri Nagnatha temple at a distance of 5 km should be the next stopover. This Nagnatha Mahadev temple is conspicuous by its splendor, even when viewed from close by the Gopi Talab. A large-sized idol of Shiva, an exquisite craftsmanship in the architecture of the temple, is what this place boasts. Apart from its celebrity as one of the 12 Jyotirlinga Kshetras, from this place, Dwaraka can be reached before evening. If time is short to go to Bed Dwaraka, Gopi Talab may be reached via Nagnatha temple, and the return journey too performed by the same route. If even that is not possible, at least the Rukmini temple nearby should be visited without fail, if the punya or merit of the pilgrimage in full measure is to be earned. It will not suffice if Dwaraka Krishna is seen just once. During the stay there, darshan should be had of the deity at various timings. Why it is said so is explained in the next chapter. If the Dwaraka, surrounded by the ocean, was created under the orders of Sri Krishna, the Dwaraka, now existing on the coast, was the making of a king. Sri Raghavendra's earliest mundane appearance was as Prahlada. The genesis of this new Dwaraka can in fact be traced to an occurrence linked with the Prahlada Avatara. The connected awe-inspiring incidents follow in the next chapter.